Good morning from Mount Stewart at the Red Squirrel Height. We're just here working on some tree work here. We've got a bit of ash dieback working its way through the woodlands here. Shaw's just about to take one of these guys out, one of our volunteers. So you can see the canopy just here, these guys looking very thin. These are all the signs of ash dieback. We saw the actual foliage decay earlier on in the year. This is another tree disease that is working its way across the UK and Ireland, and to be honest, it's going to go the same way as Dutch elms disease did. We're unlikely to see, there it goes, we're unlikely to see ash in the countryside in any way or form over the next couple of decades. It's going to absolutely decimate. Ash is a really important native species. There's hundreds of different species that solely rely on ash or partially rely on them as part of their larval stage or part of their feed stage as insects. So from a biodiversity perspective, it's not looking promising. For those of us in the sector are really quite concerned, and it's just ripping through the countryside at the moment. If anybody's watching this from the mainland UK, England, especially in Lake District and Peak District, it's just everywhere, and the cost environmentally and financially to address all this is just astronomical. So yeah, not a great video for today, but just thought it was important to talk about just some of the tree work we're doing as well. And I did say that we were going to have lots of tree work here, but also the why we're doing it. So here at the Hyde, generally speaking, obviously it's a high use area or medium use area, and we obviously need to look after people's safety, so we can't have sort of dead and decaying and limb dropping trees above the pathway or the Hyde itself. In the wider woodlands, the current approach is to actually just let it do its thing, and we're looking for resistant or resilient species, individuals that are out there that we can potentially propagate from in the future, that show some resistance to the Chilara ash dieback disease. So I'll see you next Tuesday.